name is Erin Simmons. I operate Cloudy Draw Forge Blacksmithing and Horseshoeing out of Placerville, California. I'm here to show you some of the tongs that I produce for the public and other smiths to use for their trade work. This pair just happens to be a wolf jaw. It's used for holding many different types of steel, both vertical as well as lengthwise. Very handy tool to demonstrate with because it utilizes many of the elements necessary for all the tongs, whether it be for blacksmithing or horseshoeing. What I'd like to describe for you is how I pick the type of steel and how much is allocated for each half of the tong. What I've got here is a piece of sucker rod. It's 1 inch round. It's remnant from an old drilling rig. Just measure out 5 inches. If you're the type of smith that needs a little bit of woo-woo factor, in other words, you give yourself extra in case there's a mistake that you have to correct, give yourself an extra 1/4 inch. It won't hurt anything. Step later on. So as I'm up here above, I'm pushing down ever so slightly. forged my jaw good and true, and we have a little bit of a bend. So by correcting that, I'll have everything lined up. I like a nice sweeping transition underneath the shoulder. So I can set it up here, a little daylight underneath the shoulder, round side of the hammer, just set it down. Come over to the box leg bite. Let it hang right inside the jaws. Give it a little tap. Now it's ready to go back in the fire. One side, this is the inner portion of the jaw up against the anvil. I turn it, now the outer portion of the jaw is against the anvil. And I can gauge with this hand if I'm going down or heading up. Very important. Do the same for the other side. I bring it over to the box leg vise. The jaw is in the vise. Now I can see exactly over the top of it what it needs. Give it a little twist, just that much. Now it's in line at exact 90 degrees from the jaw. Nice profile. To this shoulder, now the shoulder will be well out of the way of the opposing ring. I'll do the same to both. That's why we keep material here as your reservoir. Okay, I'm going to put it right here. That'll be good for about 3 inches round or square. Small notches on either of them. They'll be mated together like this. But the up and down, right and left, is what determines the size the tongs will hold comfortably. My critical mark right before I start. Put it in there. Now we're halfway through. Two-thirds. Pull it over, look for the halo. Now when I beat dead center of the halo, the first hole punch makes. Back the other way. Now give it. Now I can get both jaws opposed. Hot chisel to do my crosshatch marks. You can actually feel them if you can't see them. Now there are much more apparent. There we are. Now both jaws are done. Stamp going in there. And I'll take another heat to put the heart punch into it. There we are. Wolf Jaw Tongs.